Hi, I'm Kate, the Simple Biologist, and today we're going to be talking about robots. We're pretty used to seeing robots in our daily lives, like Roombas, Furbies, or hands-free car washes. But these are all clearly mechanical. They're made of metal, and they run on electricity. But what about robots printed from life? Today we're going to be talking about a paper that brought together researchers from Harvard, Sogang University, and Stanford. And what these researchers created was a new biohybrid soft robot. Part of the reason the robot these researchers built is so special is that it's in two different fields. The first field is called soft robotics, meaning that the robot is made from soft materials, like fabric, rubber, or silicone, rather than harder, more inflexible materials like metal or hard plastic. The other special thing about this robot is how it's powered. Instead of using batteries, it uses biology. Real living cells are used to power this robot, which is why it has the name Biohybrid. So now we know that these researchers built a biohybrid soft robot. But what does it look like and what does it do? The researchers wanted to mimic something that you find in real life. And so what they chose to mimic was a stingray. They wanted their robotic stingray to be able to recognize light and swim towards it, all while being about the size of a penny. So how do you go about building a robot that swims like a stingray? Well, the answer is that you go to the source and look at how stingrays themselves swim. And what you'll find if you look at a stingray is that they really need five different layers to be able to swim. From top to bottom, they need a layer of skin, a layer of muscle, a skeleton, and then another layer of muscle and another layer of skin. But if we think about making a robot, they don't really need skin. So the most important things to care about are the two layers of muscle and a skeleton. But when it comes to robotics, it's much easier to build one layer of muscle than two. The stingrays themselves need two layers of muscle because when they swim, they do this undulation motion. One layer of muscle is required to pull the fin up, and another layer is required to pull it down, leading to that smooth flowing motion. So how are we going to create a tiny robot that does all the work of two layers of muscle and a skeleton and a real stingray? The first thing needed for this robot is a body, and these researchers chose a type of silicone found in everything from contact lenses to shampoo, called dimethicone. Attached to the silicone body is a golden skeleton, chosen for its chemical inertness and for how light it is. Next is another small layer of silicone, and then finally the power of the whole stingray, a layer of printed muscle tissue. And the cells of this muscle tissue are rat heart cells. These researchers were able to get away with one layer of printed muscle tissue instead of two because they engineered the gold skeleton to spring back up after it was pulled down by the muscle tissue, kind of simulating the second layer of muscle without it actually having to be there, making the overall design a lot more simplistic and a lot more likely to work. So now we have a robot with a body, a skeleton, and a power source in the form of muscle tissue. But how do you make it swim correctly with that smooth undulation motion? And how do you make it swim correctly only in response to light? The way you have the robot respond to light is by creating a patch of specialized cells at the front of the ray. Those cells are able to sense light, and when they sense light, they contract. And not only do they contract, they then tell the cells next to them that they should contract too. And then those cells tell their neighbors, and so on and so forth. So all of the muscle cells in the ray end up contracting and pulling the fin down in response to light. The researchers also wanted the ray to be able to turn. And to do that, you need each fin to operate separately. And so you need two patches of light-sensitive cells. The message to contract will then come from those light-sensitive cells and move in a wave down each fin of the ray. All in all, the ray used about 200,000 cells to move. That's 200,000 cells in a ray about the size of a penny, and it was about the weight of a penny-sized piece of paper. It could also swim left or right, depending on where the light was placed. The side with more light would then contract more frequently, so kind of like paddling on one side of a canoe more, you turn in that direction. This robotic ray has outperformed all other kind of biohybrid soft robots, being able to go faster, travel further, and outlast any other robot created. But right now, this ray can only work in a specialized salt solution with plenty of sugar to feed the living muscle tissue. But maybe in the future, these biohybrid soft robots could function in the actual ocean. And right now, this robot can only respond to light. But maybe in the future, it can respond to nutrients, or maybe even sound. I don't know what's next for this field of robotics, but I know that this is only the beginning. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe to my channel for more science videos, or follow me on Twitter or Instagram for more science updates at SimpleBiologist. See you next time.